So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 5th and 6th of December 2022. I hope you guys are all set for today's class. So let's begin with the very first question, which is about a portal, right? So which portal has been launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, right? To boost investments in the agriculture sector and ease out the hand-holding process for the investors. So, right, this portal has been launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare to give a boost to the investment in the agriculture sector. So, you just have to tell the name of this portal. So, remember the name of the portal is Agriculture Investment Portal, or in Hindi it is Krishi Nivesh Portal. So, you should remember both the names. Okay? Agriculture Investment Portal in English and Krishi Nivesh Portal in Hindi, right? Now, as the name suggests, this portal is for boosting the investment in the agriculture and allied sectors as well. And it will be a centralized one-stop portal for all the agri investors to avail benefits of various government schemes which are being implemented by different departments, right, in the agriculture sector. For example, Agriculture Infrastructure Fund, ek scheme hai jo ki इंप्लीमेंट हो रही है इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर ताकि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बिल्डअप हो सके और उसमें क्या हो रहा है कि पैसे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट लगा रही है टू बिल्डअप द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर राइट सो ऐसे इन्वेस्टर्स जो कि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बिल्ड करना चाहते हैं दे कैन अवेल द बेनिफिट ऑफ दैट एग्रीकल्चर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फंड स्कीम राइट सो ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग सच स्कीम्स विल बी प्रोवाइडेड ऑन दिस पोर्टल एंड इन्वेस्टर्स जो होंगे उनको उसके बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन मिल पाएगी राइट सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव is to avail benefits of various government schemes implemented by various departments related to agriculture and allied sectors, right? And these are the detailed objectives. When, of course, investment hogi, so it will ease out the handholding process of the investors. It will give a boost to the investment in the agriculture sector, and of course, it will give a boost to the jo agriculture ka pura ecosystem hai, usko ek pura boost milega, right? So that is all about this portal, and just remember that it is. It has been launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Alright. So, the correct answer is option C. Krishi Nivesh Portal. Agriculture Investment Portal is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 2 then. It is about a conference which took place on women leading change in health and science in India. It was organized to honor and celebrate Indian women's accomplishments in overcoming the unprecedented challenges over the past few years and advancing STEM innovation and healthcare. STEM, I hope you all know, it is science, technology, engineering and mathematics. So where it took place? Kahan pe hua tha ye wala conference? Aapko bas itna batana hai. So remember, it took place in New Delhi, the capital of India. It took place in New Delhi, and iska jo objective hai wo already question mein hi mention tha. Agar aapne dhyan se dekha ho, the objective was to honor and celebrate Indian women's accomplishment in two areas. Number one, in overcoming the unprecedented challenges over the past few years, and in advancing the STEM innovation and healthcare. The role of women in advancing the STEM innovation, science, technology, engineering, mathematics mein innovation mein unhone is area ko STEM ko innovate karne mein unka kya role raha hai usko celebrate karne ke liye, and of course in the healthcare as well, right? It was organized by Department of Biotechnology, number one. Then Biotechnology Industry Research Association Council, Assistance Council, number two. Then Women Lift Health, which is an initiative of California University, and Grand Challenges India. So these are the four organizations which together have organized this conference, right? Now let's talk about this Women Lift Health, right? इसके बारे में पढ़ना जरूरी है थोड़ा सा, बिकॉज एक किसी एग्जाम में मैंने इसमें क्वेश्चन देखा था कि इसके बारे में पूछा गया था. सो रिमेंबर, इट इज एन इनिशिएटिव ऑफ स्टैनफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ यूएसए. इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2017, राइट? एंड व्हाट हैपेंस अंडर दिस इनिशिएटिव इज दैट इट प्रोवाइड्स अ फोरम टू एस्टैब्लिश एन इमर्जिंग लीडर्स अक्रॉस द ग्लोबल हेल्थ कम्युनिटी. पहली चीज तो यह है दैट इट इज रिलेटेड टू हेल्थ, इसके नाम भी मेंशन है विमेन लिफ्ट हेल्थ, राइट? And it provides a platform to the global leaders in the health community to meet and work together to advance the gender equity in health leadership. Number one, matlab health ke ecosystem mein gender equity ko promote karne ke liye ye sab log milenge. आपस में डिस्कशन करेंगे जितने भी ग्लोबल लीडर्स हैं। नंबर टू, कंट्रीब्यूट टू द ग्रोइंग मोमेंटम टू एडवांस डाइवर्सिटी एंड वुमेन्स लीडरशिप इन ग्लोबल हेल्थ टू रिकॉग्नाइज द वुमेन्स रोल इन ग्लोबल हेल्थ इकोसिस्टम। राइट, दीज आर द टू मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ वुमेन लिफ्ट हेल्थ। इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2017 बाय स्टैनफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी इन यूएसए। राइट, so that is all about this news and it took place in New Delhi. Option B is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 3 then. Where will be India's premier show on technical textiles, which is named as Technotex 2023? So you should remember the name of this event, Technotex, organized by Ministry of Textile, headed by Piyush Goyal, in collaboration with FICCI under National Technical Textile Mission in February 2023. So, सब कुछ इसके अंदर जो भी इसके बारे में इंपॉर्टेंट है, इस न्यूज के बारे में ऑलरेडी सब कुछ क्वेश्चन में है, तो अगर आप क्वेश्चन भी ढंग से देख लोगे तो बहुत सारी इंफॉर्मेशन आपको मिल जाएगी। सो दिस Technotex, दिस शो, यू कैन से इट्स अ प्रीमियर शो ऑन टेक्निकल टेक्सटाइल। इट विल टेक प्लेस इन मुंबई इन द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रवरी नेक्स्ट ईयर 2023। इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज अंडर नेशनल टेक्निकल टेक्सटाइल मिशन, जिसके बारे में अभी हमने रिसेंटली ही पढ़ा है। राइट, it will be organized by Ministry of Textile in collaboration with FICCI. FICCI ke saath milke Ministry of Textile isko organize karega, and it will be focused on providing its attendees the access and networking opportunities to meet the top CEOs, to meet the top entrepreneurs, to meet the top business houses which are working in the area of technical textile. All right, that is all about this Technotex, and therefore the correct answer is what? Option A, Mumbai. It will take place in Mumbai in February 2023. Let's talk about question number 4 then. It is an important question. Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has constituted an advisory group for streamlining the development of bamboo sector, which is also known as green gold, right, under restructured National Bamboo Mission. Identify incorrect statement about this mission. So let's talk about it first, then we'll come back to the question. So there is an advisory group which has been constituted by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Kisliye banaya gaya hai ye? To advise government on issues and challenges or technologies in propagation, plantation of bamboo, intercropping, primary processing, marketing, skill development in this area. तो बैंबू सेक्टर को डेवलप करने के लिए, जो पूरा बैंबू का इकोसिस्टम है उसको डेवलप करने के लिए, देर इज अ मिशन विच इज रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड नेशनल बैंबू मिशन। And this advisory group will advise the government on how we can develop this ecosystem and how we can create the employment opportunities in this ecosystem. Right? So this is an advisory group. And remember, this advisory group consists of Union Agriculture Secretary as the chairperson, and whoever is the mission director of National Bamboo Mission is the convener of this advisory group. And there are various other stakeholders as well, like researchers, innovators, entrepreneurs, स्किल डेवलपर्स, बाकी सभी लोग जो इस एरिया में काम कर रहे हैं या करना चाहते हैं, दे विल बी दे आर इनफैक्ट द मेंबर्स ऑफ एडवाइजरी ग्रुप। राइट, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस मिशन, रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन। तो ऑब्जेक्टिव इज वेरी क्लियर, टू ब्रिंग द बैम्बू रिसोर्सेज इन टू द मार्केट वैल्यू चेन, टू रिड्यूस इंपोर्ट एंड इंप्रूव लाइवलीहुड एंड बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज, बेसिकली to develop the bamboo ecosystem, to create the employment opportunities, to create livelihood for the people, to bring the bamboo into the market value chain. So basically, bamboo ko develop karne ke liye, bamboo se fayda lene ke liye, this mission is being implemented, right? It is a centrally sponsored scheme and the restructured one. Theek hai, that this initially only National Bamboo Mission was launched in 2006, but it was restructured in the year 2018. राइट, तो रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड मिशन कब लॉन्च हुआ? 2018 में। एंड जो पहले नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन था वो 2006 में लॉन्च हुआ था, तो बहुत पुराना मिशन है ये। एंड दिस रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड एनडीएम इंक्लूड्स मार्केट वैल्यू एडिशन, प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट, प्रोडक्ट मैनेजमेंट, स्किल डेवलपमेंट, रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स, एनहेंसिंग द लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटीज एटसेट्रा। इट इज बींग इंप्लीमेंटेड अंडर नेशनल मिशन फॉर सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर, बिकॉज नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन is a part of National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture, and it is being implemented in 23 states and UTs across the country, including all the northeastern states and hilly states and Union Territory of Jammu Kashmir. Right, 23 states, including the northeastern and hilly states and union territory of Jammu and Kashmir, right? So there is only one union territory, that is Jammu and Kashmir. Let's talk about funding pattern then, 60-40 between center and state government for all state. Since it is a centrally sponsored scheme, what is the difference? I hope you all know this. There are two types of schemes, centrally sponsored and central sector. In central sector scheme, the entire funding is provided by the central government. While in centrally sponsored schemes, the funding is shared between the central government and the state governments, right? And that is why there is a ratio of 60-40 between center and state government for all states, right? 60-40. 90-10 between center and northeastern and hilly states, ठीक है? अगर वो northeastern और hilly states है, तो ratio हो जाएगा 90-10, मतलब 90% by the central government and 10% by that northeastern or hilly state. And 100% funding will be provided by the central government if it is the case of Union Territory, Research and Development Institute, Bamboo Technology Support Groups and National Level Agencies. Alright. So, this is the funding pattern. I hope this is clear. And now, let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement about this mission. It is a centrally sponsored scheme. Yes. It was launched in 2018. Yes. See, restructured national bamboo mission agar likha hua aayega, to you have to write the launch year as 2018 and not 2006. Please don't get confused here. It has been initiated under National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. No problem. Correct hai. It includes market, value addition, product development, skill and R&D components which were not present in original NDM. Ye bhi bilkul sahi baat hai. And it is being implemented in all states and UTs. Nahi. Ye baat bilkul sahi nahi hai. It is being implemented in 23 states and one union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So therefore, the correct answer will be option E. Right? Option E is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5. Question number 5 says, which international organization has recently organized opening ceremony for the International Year of Millets 2023 in Rome, Italy? This organization is headquartered in Rome. ठीक है? And I hope you have identified it. It is Food and Agricultural Organization. Option E is the correct answer. And there is no need of further details of this question. Not required at all. As a part of neighborhood first policy, India is building capacities of civil servants of neighboring countries, and India is also building capacities of its own civil servants through Mission Karma Yogi. Right? Mission Karma Yogi ke baare mein abhi humne ek do class pehle hi padha hai. And India is also building the capacity of civil servants overseas, jo neighboring countries hai unke. To meet the emerging challenges in governance and assured public service delivery to improve the quality of life of people. With which country National Center for Good Governance has entered into an MOU for capacity building of their 1000 civil servants by 2024? Very, very important question. I hope ye aapke exam mein aayega. I believe ye aapke exam mein aana chahiye. So this country in question is Maldives. Option E is the correct answer. Question number 7. The flagship event of India-Sweden Nobel Memorial Week, which is named as SheSTEM 2022, right? Remember the name of the countries, India and Sweden, was recently held in New Delhi, where it took place in New Delhi, right? It aims to celebrate contribution of women innovators, technologists, scientists and founders in the fields of science, technology, engineering and mathematics and sustainability. The objective of this event, it was organized by Embassy of Sweden in India in partnership with German Center of Innovation and Research and which of the following organizations, right? So, in this question, mein, is news ki sari information hai. Isiliye alag se news isme nahi banayi gayi hai. To dekho, pehli cheez to ye hai, SheSTEM 2020. Theek hai? It is the event of which two countries? India, Sweden, number one. And where it took place? It took place in New Delhi, number two. What is the objective? This is the objective number 3. And which organizations or which bodies organized it? So these are the organizations. Embassy of Sweden in India, partnership with German Center for Innovation and Research in collaboration with Niti Aayog. Option D is the correct answer. Aage chalte hai, question number 8 pe. Where was National Conference on Soil Health Management for Sustainable Farming organized by Niti Aayog in collaboration with JIS, which is a German development agency, Right, so it took place again in New Delhi. Option D is the correct answer once again. Question number 9. The fifth edition of European Union India Competition Week 2022, right? It was recently inaugurated in New Delhi. Which organization from Indian side is organizing this event? So, India ki taraf se kaun hai? So, India ki taraf se hai Competition Commission of India. Option C is the correct answer. And the last question for today. Recently, National Highway Authority of India and Maharashtra Metro was awarded Guinness Book of World Record for constructing world's longest double-decker viaduct with highway flyover and metro rail supported on single column. Where is this project located in Maharashtra? Right? आपको बस इतना बताना है कि ये जो प्रोजेक्ट है जिसको गिनीज बुक ऑफ वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड मिला है ये प्रोजेक्ट कहां पे है. सो इट इज इन नागपुर. ऑप्शन इज द करेक्ट आंसर, द सिटी ऑफ ऑरेंजेस. ऑलराइट गाइस, सो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन मंडे. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.